Hi students, welcome to my channel. Today AP triple IIT entrance physical science model paper 4. Once again I wish you all the best. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Today's first question on the screen: biconvex lens converges the parallel rays of principal axis at 10 centimeters. Means bifocal lens kumbhakara katakamu em chestundi converge the parallel rays on the principal axis at 10 centimeters. So parallel rays no 10 cm principal axis meeda focus akada 10 cm dooramlo converge ante focus chestundi. So that focal length is, so the distance between the pole and the converging point is nothing but focal length 10 cm. Then a lens which has two spherical surfaces bulging outwards. So bulging outwards is double convex lens. So bulging inwards aithe curved inwards anadite double concave lens. Next question on the screen: the parts marked in the diagram are, so it is convex lens, it is convex lens anamata. So it is surface 1, it is surface 2, so it is the sphere of ear epakuntundi center ee vaipu untundi kabatti, so deeni yokka ee vaipu untayi kabatti 1 is the 2f2, 2 is the f2, 3 is the f1, 4 is the 2f1. Option B is correct. The doctor checked the body temperature of the 10th class student and said his body temperature is 310 Kelvin. So body temperature of the student is 310 Kelvin. The body temperature of the boy in Celsius scale is, so here a temperature is given in Kelvin scale. To convert into Celsius scale, we have to know that subtract 273, subtract 273 from Kelvin scale. So Kelvin scale ushnagrata ichinappudu em cheyali, Celsius like marchalante 273 teesseyala. So 310 inch 273 teeseste we get 37°C. So 310 minus 273, that is equal to 37°C. In the below graph, temperature decreases, volume decreases. So temperature decrease aithe volume kuda decrease avutundi. This phenomenon is called, generally temperature decrease aithe volume increase kavali, ikkada decrease avutundi. This phenomenon is called anomalous expansion of water. It is anomalous expansion of water anamata. The chemical used in fire extinguishers, so nippun arpadamlo agnini arpadamlo upayoginche chemical ledi, sodium bicarbonate baking soda, as it releases carbon dioxide with acids. This carbon dioxide is used as fire extinguisher. Next, a student added few drops of universal indicator to given colorless sample and he observed the sample turned to red. So universal indicator no colorless sample kalipinapudu em ayindi turns into red. Then the nature of the sample is, it is nothing but acid. Universal indicator gives red color with strong acids or acids anamata. A student is performing a glass slab experiment. Which of the following is precaution need not take? So glass slab tho experiment cheyatappudu which of the following precaution need not be taken? Sudma, all lines are drawn thin, it is right. Only one eye is used in fixing two pins on the other side of the slab, it is also correct. All pins are fixed vertical, it is also correct. So these three precautions should be taken while doing glass slab experiment. So which one is the need not be taken is the option D. So the first two pins for incident ray are fixed by looking through the glass slab. So by fix, the first two pins will be fixed without looking through the glass slab. It is the option correct. Next, refractive index of water is 4/3. N is equal to 4/3. N is equal to 4/3. N of water is not. The speed of light in water is given. Kanukola, you know that refractive index N is equal to C/V. C/V. So speed of light in water V is equal to C/N. C/N. So C is nothing but speed of light in vacuum, which is equal to 3 × 10^8. 10^8. So 3 × 10^8 by refractive index of water 4/3. 4/3. 4/3. So if you simplify that 4/3, ikkada koste em avutundi 3/4 avutundi. 3 × 3 = 9 avutundi. Got 9/4 × 10^8 meters per second. Next question on the screen 60. See the figure. Parallel rays of light fall on eye and they converge before the retina. So parallel rays of light when fall on the eye lens, it forms the image before the retina. It represents a certain defect in the eye. To correct it, dash lens is used. So this defect is known as the myopia. It is known as myopia. To convert it, we have to use biconcave lens. So when the image is formed by the eye lens is before the retina, then the person is suffering from myopia. So to correct the myopia, we have to use biconcave lens. Next question, the eye lens adjusts its focal length between. So eye lens adjusts its focal length with the help of ciliary muscles and between. Tell me, yeah, 2.27 and 2.5, rendu madhyane adi adjust avutu untundi. Next, X atomic line spectra arise because of adsorption or emission of certain frequency of light energy. Yeah, correct. The lines in atomic spectra can be used to identify unknown atoms. So both are correct. Both X and Y are correct option. Next, which of the following cell has the maximum number of electrons here? 32. So maximum number of electrons in a given cell is equal to 2n square. So 2n square is equal to 32. So 2 y poste em avutundi, n square is equal to 32/2 is equal to 16. N square is equal to 16, n is equal to 4. So we get simplification chesthe n is equal to 4 vastundi. So 2n square is equal to 32 given. So then undi 2 away pampiste 32/2 16 avutundi. N square is 16 avuthe n is equal to 4. Fourth cell is KLMN. N is the fourth cell. Option N A, that is nth cell, is the has the maximum number of 32 electrons. Next question, which one shrinks in size than atom? Which one shrinks in size than an atom? So when the electrons removed from the neutral atom, then due to more nuclear charge, it shrinks. So positive ion shrinks than its atom. So Na plus is the option correct. That is option A, only one anamata. Next, assert Mendeleev was placed beryllium, magnesium, calcium in one group. All are in the second group. You know that. Then when beryllium, magnesium, calcium react with oxygen and form beryllium oxide, magnesium oxide, calcium oxide. Next, what is the? So all the beryllium, magnesium, calcium in one group, say second group, so their valence is 2. When they react with oxygen, they form oxides BeO, MgO. So both assertion and reason are correct, and R is supporter to A. Option A is correct. Next question, electronic configuration of metal M is. 4s1 and non-metal x is 3s2 3p5. The formula of ionic compound formed between these two elements is, so 4s1 it has valency 1. So 3s2 3p5 pi plus 2 7 it has valency 8 minus 7 is equal to 1. Both the elements m and x have same valency 1 1, so their formula must be mx. So it has only one valence electron, so its valence is 1. It has 5 plus 2 7 valence electrons, so when there is more than 4 valence electron, then their valency is 8 minus valence electron, 8 minus 7, so 1. So both have same valency 1 1, so their formula is mx. Choose the correct statement relating to the properties of covalent compound. Properties of covalent compounds. Covalent compound do not exist as ions, so they exist as molecules. It is correct one. The melting and boiling points of the covalent compounds are generally low. It is also correct one. It is also correct one. Next, these are poor conductors of electricity. Also correct one. These are generally insoluble in water and soluble in other polar solvents. So which one is correct? All or others or options are correct. Find the incorrect statement or statements from the following. Incorrect statements or statement from the following. A resistance of a conductor depends upon the material. It is the correct statement. Resistance of a conductor is independent of the area of the cross section. So it is also depend on the area of the cross section. It is wrong statement. Resistance of the conductor depends on its length. It is also correct statement. Resistance of a conductor is independent of the temperature. It is also wrong statement. So resistance increase with increase of temperature. Resistance increase with increase of length. Resistance increase with decrease of area of the cross section. So options 1 and 3 are correct. 1 and 3 are correct. Incorrect statements mark 2 and 4. Option C is correct. Option C is correct. Next, observe the circuit. The power consumed by the resistor R2 is P, and the power consumed by the resistor R2 when the resistor R1 is removed. Here, observe the resistor. Here, these two are in parallel connection. R1, R2 are in parallel connection. Since they are parallel connection, which one? Both have consumed the same power. So if one of them is removed, the other is also same power P. Next, the instrument used to check the EMF of the battery. EMF of the battery is nothing but potential difference or voltage. That is voltmeter used to check the EMF of the battery. Next one, this curve shows the relation between flux and time. At which time interval the EMF is not induced in the loop. So when there is a change in the flux with the time interval, the induced EMF will be produced. While there is, if there is no change in the flux, rate of flux is not changing. So here if you observe in the graph from 2 to 4, in this time interval, the graph is parallel to time axis. So in this there is no change in the flux. So flux is same. So there is no change in flux. So no induced current is produced in the loop. So option A is the correct option. Next question on the screen. Alloy metals does not undergo corrosion. So alloys does not undergo corrosion. It is true. Alloying process prevents the surface of the metallic object to come contact with atmosphere, both are correct, but it is not the option. So A is true, but R is false. Next, sodium, magnesium, zinc, iron, silver, and Au are the few metals of reactivity series of metals. Iron is moderate reactive metal. Iron, zinc are moderate reactive metal. These two are moderate reactive metals. These two are low reactive metals. These two are highly reactive metals. Fe is moderate reactive metal. It is correct. Magnesium not a moderate. It is not a moderate reactive metal, but it is highly reactive metal. So both Ramu and Raju are correct. Both Ramu and Raju are correct. Next question: which one of the following statements are usually correct for carbon compounds? Correct statements ma. These are good conductors of electricity. It is wrong one. Organic compounds are covalent compounds, so they are poor conductors of electricity. B is correct. Have strong force of attraction. No, there is not strong force, weak forces of attraction between their molecules. So option B and D. B and D. So option D is the correct answer. Next question on the screen. Amount of 5 ml of each acetic acid and water are mixed together and shaken well. So acetic acid and water, these two are mixed at all proportions and forms homogeneous mixture. In one acid and water, there is separate layer. It is wrong one. Similarly, here also acid water separate layer. It is also wrong one. Heterogeneous mixture, it is also wrong one. So both will mix each other and forms homogeneous mixture. So option 4 is correct. Option D is correct. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Okay, thank you. Bye. Thank you.